Okay, the date is March 13th. It's Sunday, 2015. I just put these out here because, you know, everything's getting so crowded in the house. On those two shelves is all we can really use on that cart. These things have to be on top, and we got those trays in the middle on the second shelf, which is now on top for a while. Brought these out here. That pepper is 19 inches tall. I measured that this morning. This tomato is a German Johnson. This is approximately 17 inches, I believe I measured that. So then 16, 15, and about that Merlot is about 15 inches, 14, about 14 inches tall. And then you got your Castelluto, again, would be about 13, 12, about 10 inches in. And I don't know, this one here, we put the name in here, Sioux tomato. And Cherokee tomato. I don't have anything on this one here. You don't know what happened to the name on this one, do you? No, she's not there. I had one of those sticks with a piece of masking tape. So these three right here are Merlots. See, they were all grown in one of those little... I don't have anyone handily right around me. What happened? The wind must have blown them off. Those little square plastic planters. The wind out here has been really, really, really unnatural and very heavy. So we have to kind of keep an eye on these out here. It's 10:10 on a Sunday. It's around, see how the wind is right there? That's, for these little plants, it's okay just right here. If it gets much wind in the air, they're going to have to go back in the house again. I got that pepper down there. It's got a skew on it, one of those 18-inch skews tied to it. Let me see it down there. So you got your shish kebab on a grill and all that. It's about 18 inches long with a point at one end, and then most people know what they are, so. But, you know. Merlot, German Johnson, Rutgers, another Merlot, but that's another nice Merlot right there. Other than just the correction for focusing, that's the one downside I don't like. You know, instantaneous, I'm always wanting instantaneous everything, but for a $300 digital camera video, this is a pretty good camera. That's the Castelluto. It's a heirloom tomato. You know, so see the wind, like I say, it's moving them. If it gets kind of breezy out here now, it's 10:10 or 10:15, I have to bring them back in the house. That right there, I've had down in that big planter down there in the middle, like I did that pepper plant. I just put that soil around it. I have a little bit left of this potting soil, which is really, really rare. This is something I can't say enough about. At Lowe's, we got them for like $3.50 or so for a 32-quart bag. All right, focus now. Come on. See, 32 quarts. And this is... what I put, I really recommend. A lot of people use the potting soil, and not potting soil, the growing soil, the garden soil, all that crap. No, I've had much better, I've used those, I've had 10 times better results from the potting soil, and this is a decent one, it seems, because, you know, well, look, just a question of the wind now. So, these will sit out here for about 4 hours, 5 hours, unless the wind starts picking up too much. But, you know, they say they acclimate them a few hours at a time until it gets to the point where you can take them out there. The plastic out there was redone Wednesday or Tuesday. Tracy and I were out there doing that. And then the storms came up and ripped it all up, basically. And I was out there trying to patch up on the far end over there. Nope, I'm pointing at the wrong area. I'm looking straight down here. Out there. See, I was looking with my eyes, not with the camera, so... But I did the far back over there, it's about 55 feet across. I put the soil on the edge again. In the middle aisle there, that's where it's kind of up and about a third of it. on the far, let's see, I have to zoom out to get focus on here. On the far east end that way, I got that mostly covered again. I mean, Tracy had it all by hand. She was on her hands and knees down there burying all that. And then the side over here, she did about half of that west end right there. And then I did all the way to the corner, and that had been blown up from the wind. So I used a pointed hoe, not to be confused with a whore, a pointed hoe, and buried it again. So it still needs, I like it neat myself. It won't be really perfect, but I want to go out there, take the hole and kind of like make it an edge, you know, pull it to an edge, you know, like that all the way around. But it's nice out here. That's why I brought these out. Let's look at the ones we got in here on the cart. Oh, yeah. See, that shelf down there, it's kind of difficult. They get sun, but, you know, it's not the best. It's something, let's put it that way. And we had this one. This is the tomatoes, I think. No, this is the peppers. We had the peppers down there. I replanted. I put two seeds in all these all over again. The orange bell right here. Red peppers, which is the Beaver Dam, I believe. Keystone, which is like your green bell pepper, technically. Don't recall what I did, if I even put anything in these two. This one here is, I can't even read it. Turn it. I can't even read that good. Damn. Anyway, and then here we got peppercini, which are the ones like you see on the Papa John pizzas. They give those long peppers that they put on. That's what these are. I'm not sure on these, though. See, like I said, after I mixed these around, I didn't have labels on them. I had them on the end. But then moved them around and added seeds to them. Now I know what's in here, but these two I don't. These I don't remember what they are. There's two pepper plants in this one. Three in this one here. Three and the one in front of it here and one coming up there. It don't look so great right there either. That one's not looking really healthy. Focus, there it is. And then we have tomatoes here again. Don't know what's in these tomatoes except this one here. It's Rutgers. That's about 4 inches tall right there. These two, I don't know. I don't know why the tape's off this one, so I couldn't tell you what it is. That one there. Well, see, it says Marglobe, so it might be Marglobe in this aisle here, this row. See, but like once those get put out there, I'm going to use like these pots here. Don't really want to use these over again. I will if I have to, but you know, these give them another chance now. A couple days ago is when I replanted these. Jeez, I almost knocked that over. But those clay pots are about four of these at Lowe's. I forget the exact price, but those were really a good deal. I prefer clay pots, but the plastic crap is all most stores have. So even that one down there, that's a plastic pot inside a plastic pot. Plastic pot. These are from knockout roses that we got out front. Use these even. That's what the come on. Different sizes. Plastic pot. The knockout roses. That's what those are from. But all plastic except for the. Those are about. I think those are considered. I think they call those pint pot size. These here. That's what pots always used to be right there. The clay pot. So, if I can get about 5 bags of this, 4 of them will go in the side garden over there for the peppers. You can't really see from this angle. I got cinder blocks in that board right there, but I'm bringing cinder blocks over from that garden as we get the plastic buried. So I might end up using that for that board. I might put 3 or 4 cinder blocks there on the end. Not walking out in the grass. Contaminated rain and such on the grass. Got those, my wife says they're clovers, the purple flower clovers, purple clover, whatever the heck, anyway. But you can see the flooding out here. See the lakes out there? I think it was Wednesday into Thursday. that was totally flooded over there, all that, and we had it coming over our driveway into our little drain ditch in the center, which is going down. It's flowing still like a little stream, but it's all going down. It's not supposed to rain, so maybe tomorrow, next day, tomorrow's Monday, Monday or Tuesday, I'll be out in the garden and try to finish off that plant. It's going to be muddy because I tried doing it yesterday a little bit in between the rain, but it is kind of muddy. So I'll go out there and see if I can't, see the middle one I can't do. I can't go in the middle aisle there because that's just all mud going down along the side of the long garden and our short garden where I had planted onion seeds in three rows. I was going to do four. I did three rows, but then with all the rain, it's all washed up over there. So anyway, it'll get done. I got all these flowers I want to get out here too that you can sow right into the soil. Because now it should not ever get down below 44, 45 degrees at night. You know, that's, I'd rather be 50 or warmer at night, but you know, 45 or better is okay for seeds to start out because they'll sit and be dormant for a while and then they'll start germinating as it gets warmer out. But, I mean, we'll have some flowers all around three sides of the garden, three different types, two types of the yellow ones and the torch, which are the orange ones that most of the hummingbirds and honeybees were going to big time last year. And the big winged butterflies, man, that is really, this year should be really, really pretty. Again, unless the mafia that's in the District of Criminals, I almost said Columbia, but it's not true, it's the District of Criminals, unless they do something. So, you'll know. I mean, when they start giving stuff about no gardens and all that, you know right there, that's all bull. And you need to fight that. And if you don't, you don't need to say a damn thing. Whatever they dish in your face, you better take a bite, chew, swallow, repeat. Just like on The Walking Dead. Take a piece of shit, take a bite, chew, swallow, repeat. So anyway, I'm going to do what I can. You know, I wish to goodness more of you would do what you can. I'm sure more and more people are, but like I said, being here and being trapped on the porch, I don't want to walk out onto the contaminated grass. It's bad enough that I'm going to grow heirloom vegetables in contaminated soil from the contaminated rain, from the contaminated chemtrails. But it's still 10 times better than the crap you'll buy in the China Mart and the other stores out there. Unless they're grown in a, what do you call it, that? A greenhouse by an heirloom place that takes real pride. Heirloom Solutions has been the one place I've dealt with, and I'm very, very appreciative of their help, even calling them. I think it's Thompson, Illinois, where they're located. But Heirloom Solutions is a great place. One seed, one plant. That's how I've always done this. And that's why I can't understand. I wasted or somehow lost some seeds because I had... See, they were giving you a large amount of seeds, which was really good deal. Now they seem to cut down for whatever reason. But I use one seed for each plant. I didn't put like two or three seeds in there and see which one's the strongest. It's like here, there were four seeds in a planter. And that's Miracle. This is five seeds in this. I put five seeds accidentally. I meant put four. And then I put, threw two in. I put two more in eventually. And that's the biggest one. I put it in there, transplant. Now these three were doing good. Plus you've seen the ones in the house. So I just transplanted these three into this pot. You know, I mean, this pot here, they can get as big as, you know, these here. But just got to be careful when we're digging them out to put them in, transplant them. Plus the ones in the soil, in the small planters in the house. This here, I'm thinking about maybe using that real big one. But see, I don't want to use up my little bit of soil here. I could use this for smaller pots still. That's why I wish I had five bags right now. Can't afford it. I gotta wait until the government gives me the money that's due to me that I've paid in for 40 years, and now I get hurt, and now I get supposed to get disability because they don't have any more nutrition in the ground, the farmlands out here. They stripped them and never did what they took care of it. They were never good stewards of the land. They're just all about profit. So anyway, it's a long video. I understand that. But that's the condition right now as of the 13th of March, 2016. It's about 10:20 right now. See, there, here comes the wind. This happens all the time now. If the wind's going to be really bad like this, I'm going to have to bring these back in, which really is going to, excuse my mouth, piss me off. But anyway, see, there it goes. This is what we've had to contend with for 3 years out here. oh, you're out in the open. No, this is unusually strong. You know, when they, you look on WeatherBug, it says 6 mile an hour, 4 mile an hour. It's never been calm. I've never seen anything below 4 mile an hour, which that's what they have on WeatherBug. And you come out here and it's like this right here. It's probably about 8 to 10 miles an hour winds with 20 mile an hour, 25 mile an hour, 30 mile an hour wind gusts. Because we're out in the open. We got that big garden over there. Not big, but bigger than most. And then that's what's going to happen. That's why I got to be careful with these tomato plants. I don't want the wind breaking these things. So if it starts getting windy again, they're going to have to go back in the house. Look at that. A little wind is fine. That helps build up the, you know, the strength of the plant. But when it's getting too hard, I'm going to have to bring them in or maybe even set them down the bottom. I don't know if that'll help any. I'll put them down there and see how much the wind blows on them. You know, right down where I'm talking about. Down right next to that old makeup case when I was Ozzy Osbourne look-alike. I used a lot of eye makeup and such. Pull this big one away from that little table and then maybe put a few plants around the front of it. Front of it down there. We'll see. I just have to keep an eye out here. Now I'll transfer this. Whisper, W-I-S-P-E-R in Alamo, which is probably about 20 miles, 21 miles over there. I wouldn't say directly. I'd say between that area right there and right there behind that shed. About 21 miles, and there's a tower over there, probably about maybe 8 miles in Salem. It's tower to tower. That's how we get our internet out here. And they really, really, really suck. I mean, we've been out for 3 or 4 days, and because it was a tower issue, they won't give me a credit for that. But, you know, it doesn't make no difference with them. They're like that all the time. Well, we're trying. Yeah, it's great and fun. But see, we're out here in the open, and there's nothing around us. That's an empty barn way over there. Up in the background, it's about a mile away up there, that house up in the background. All right, let me see if I can get that. The house up there, it was a barn converted into a house. That's about a mile from our house. Oh, just under a mile, I should say. Just under a mile. That's the closest. The other one is on the other side over there. It's about a mile. If you go by the tracks, it's just short of a mile, about 1,500 feet short of a mile, because if you leave the driveway and go all the way around back over to the railroad tracks right over there, it'll come through here. There's a railroad crossing right there. That's exactly 1 mile from those tracks to right here. So this is, you know, this is what we have out here. We're out in the open at the whim of MAN-GAWD playing with the weather. Look, those are actual clouds up in the sky, folks. I mean, I'm sure they got some stuff spread out in them, but those are actual clouds. I really hate breathing this crap. I really do. I don't come out much. Storm back, and most of the time I have one of those surgical masks on my face because of this. You're a fool if you think that's stupid, because, well, we'll see what happens in about 10 years from now if this country is standing. We'll be a different country. It won't be the same. They're already doing it. Donald Trump can help everybody out of an ocean shipwreck, and they get them in the boat, and they get them back to shore, and they say it was Donald Trump's fault that they were in the ocean. So, you know, there's nothing that's going to be done that's going to change that. The protesters at his private conventions or whatever you want to call them stops, and they blame Trump for the guys who come in there and cause all the problems, that throw the first swing and so forth. But it's always going to be Donald Trump's fault, because it's not going to be, well, it's being said that that's not going to be the same with him. It's going to be worse, which, again, you know, question the motives, and if you don't, well, you deserve what's coming. That's why I say I'm giving myself a free out here. I'm saying I don't deserve any of the bullshit. Excuse my mouth. But you know what? I'm the one who's out here showing this. I can't do anything other than this, at least. I'm doing something. I'm putting it out there for the masses, and let's listen to all the people who are arguing out there. Listen, okay, I'm going to give it about 10 seconds. Did you hear all that? Yeah, me too. There you go. That's why everything's like it is. Take a bite, chew, swallow. Take a bite, chew, swallow.